I've been authoring e-learning since we adopted Microsoft Outlook way back in the day and wanted to train everybody on email and realised that we couldn't do it in the time available in a classroom session. So we got hold of a little product called Opus and we created our first e-learning, ran it on our intranet and never looked back. So I was then doing simulations of PACS, our results reporting systems, infection control and our IT induction. And in 2005 we went over to an LMS, which we call a managed learning environment, or EMILE, who everybody hates. But it's become invaluable for us for delivering and recording training. And I haven't created an app before. I'm ahead of David because I actually got my smartphone about a fortnight before I signed up for this project, so hey. And our trust wanted to take part because we do want to look at other ways apart from our EMILE to deliver that learning. Users are now just preferring other devices rather than a conventional PC. So we've got to look at other ways of doing this. And I particularly want to see if the simulations that I create could be put onto a mobile phone app. As I say, the EMILE is not universally loved. It can be difficult to access. It doesn't like running on Macs. It doesn't like certain browsers. And the ability to put in lots of detail can make the learning cumbersome. And it's now got a reputation for being a bit dreary. Nothing that I've created, of course. We've brought in mandatory training. There's a hell of a lot of stuff in there, and people just don't. You hear them groan when you say it's on the EMILE. So we've got to look at other ways of providing things. And also, we do like to try and send out a link to our EMILE to new starters before they start the rotational doctors and get them to do their learning before they get to us. So if they can't actually access it, they're not very chuffed. So EMILE, dreary, boring. Apps, fun, exciting, handy and useful. So we wanted to explore delivering bite-sized chunks of learning so people don't have to go through, get bogged down in lots of stuff that they don't actually need to do, or those functionalities which are very nice to know, but at the end of the day they don't need them. So what to choose? We wanted something that was fairly straightforward and would be short and simple. And tQuest is a part of our system called Review that we now use for viewing test results, and this is the part of it where you can actually request electronically as well. So this is my little page on GoMo showing how I'm actually starting to put it together. So it's very simple to use. You just drop in bits of text and images. And I've started off there with an image of the whole of the tQuest page. That is zoomable, so that you can look into that a bit closer. But I do have the problem, when I'm doing the screenshots, they do look like the real thing. So I'm a bit concerned that people will find that frustrating, that they'll be clicking and tapping and won't go anywhere. I've put a hotspot on the little on the R there, which is the area that they need to click on when they're using the actual product. So I would have liked the tapping on there to go onto the next page, but in fact they need to just slide onto it. And when you're authoring, you do need to think about things a bit differently and pare down all the text. It's so tempting to put in loads of stuff per page, but I think lots of small pages, little bits of text on there, and also not to make it so people have to scroll down, because I don't think they like scrolling down, just like going across. I haven't really done very much yet design-wise. I've been looking more at the sort of thing that I've been doing so far. You can put in coloured backgrounds and all this kind of thing just to jazz it all up. GoMo doesn't particularly like working on our network. I have to do it outside of the network at work. And then it's a bit frustrating because we don't have Wi-Fi access. So I then go home and download it on my smartphone and test it out at home. So there are all those little things there that you need to take into account. but it's been quite a good experience doing this. On this one, I've got the main area of interest, and then down below I've put in that main shot again with a line around it just to show where that's going to be. On our network at the moment, we can't really support video or sound, so I've not been used to put that into e-learning, but hey, I think we can get all sorts of things into a mobile app.